What is CQRS design pattern? CQRS stands for Command Query Responsibilities Segregation. It sounds very complicated, but it is not that complicated. Let's take an example. Suppose you have an order system. It is taking millions of orders. You have deployed on the cloud. And this is a typical application. You have a presentation layer, you have a business layer, and you have a data access layer. Business layer is where all your business logics are there, all your business objects are there, you are performing validation. Is this credit card is valid for this order? Do we have item in the inventory? And persistence layer is the one which is saving these orders into the system. Imagine million of records are trying to update inventory status, order, taking order, finding out the balance, all those calculations are going on. And there is a lot of pressure on the database. Database has to render the querying part. It has to write to the record, make sure it logs the record. And before it can update, the problem, there can be huge data contention problem. And you want to make sure you take all the orders. You should never ever lose an order. Losing order means losing business for the company. So what's the solution for this problem? The problem solution is simple. Have two databases, one for writing the database, writing orders, and one for reading the orders. So that's what command query segregations are responsibilities are. So you write command components which are separate, which are just responsible for updating data in the database, and the querying database are responsible only for querying the database, reading all the select statements go to that one. Generally, the command patterns, they use event sourcing. Check out event sourcing design pattern. I'll put the link down. So all the commands are mostly command specific. So we can see if we don't use CQRS, we have a performance problem. Too many records are trying to update the database, trying to read. There are timeout problem, and the database is the bottleneck. You cannot scale this application, and the security of the there, everybody can access the order. You have to make sure that it is secured. The order can be processed only by the person who's supposed to update. So the benefit, so we can see that here comes CQRS design pattern. When you are writing to the database, you need to have very few indexes. You want to have a very normalized database, so that because when you are saving orders, consistency, reliability, and accuracy is very, very important. And you want to make sure you have a normalized database so that you are not updating too many fields. The order is right. You have the right address. You have the right amount. Whereas when you are reading, you are more concerned about denormalized form. When you are writing queries, you have to have a lot of indexes on the database. So this way you can tune both databases independently. What are the benefits of CQRS design pattern? The first is read versus write optimization. Generally, you will have a lot of read queries, and as compared to read, less write operations. So you can tune these differently. I mentioned for writing, you would need to have very few indexes, whereas over writing, you will whereas about reading, you will need a lot of indexes. The second is a schema. As I said, when you are taking orders, you need schema to be highly normalized so that there is a data consistency. There's no duplication of data. and the data is good in good reliable good, whereas when you are reading that you need data base to be highly denormalized, so there are less joins, you can get faster results. Using CQRS, you can maintain better security because only the applications which are responsible for writing, validating that business logic, you are making sure your business validation logic is centralized and is reliable. And we can see the separation. There's a good separation of concerns. Read versus write, that means all write operations are in write application, whereas read or data, querying application could be different. So when to use CQRS design pattern? When you have a lot of domains trying to update the same data, then it's very good to have CQRS event processing. As I said, you use CQRS with event sourcing, and in event sourcing you schedule your processes as events. It could be asynchronous messaging, so you can build it's very good for building complex operations when your screen is complex, and also if your application has a lot of read as compared to write, and you have some separate developers, different developers are working for writing transactional systems which are recording orders, and different developers are responsible for writing reporting system which are reading from the read-only database and generating reports fast. You need a versioning of the domain object, which the business logic is complex. You need to centralize, make sure only couple applications which are updating has maintaining good version update, business update version, and it's also good where you need a fault tolerance. As I said, in cloud you have a million of transactions going on, somewhere process is stuck. Using event based, you can restart it at any point of time. So when not to use CQRS? CQRS can add a lot of complexity to your application. If your application is simple, there's not much of business validation, it's just a CRUD screens where you are doing a maintenance screens, where you are inserting record, updating, deleting, and making very few select statements. So it's not good to use CQRS in that kind of pattern. So that's CQRS design pattern. CQRS is about segregating command and query responsibilities, so that you can scale, tune them independently. So thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, like it, share it, and subscribe to this channel for regular updates. Thanks for watching.